Before we can do any of that, we have got to finish our story. I am so glad that you are back. We are in Egypt, and God is continuing to use Moses to do amazing things. Moses did not think he was up for the job, but God had a special plan for Moses. After returning to Egypt, Moses and his brother Aaron had been talking and talking to Pharaoh, asking him to let the people go. But Pharaoh keeps saying no. However, Pharaoh is stubborn. Even after all those plagues God brought on the Egyptians, Pharaoh would not let the people go. Did any of you guys throw hailstones at Pharaoh last night?
Yeah.
Well, I hate to tell you this, but now he's madder than ever, and he's making those slaves work even harder. Pharaoh still has a lesson to learn, because God is going to be faithful to his people.
Dark again. I'm so tired of the dark. Dark, 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 dark. At least this time it's dark because it's nighttime. I'm so bored. And I'm hungry. Taskmasters! Then why are you yawning and rubbing your eyes and stretching? A gnat! One of those pesky flies! Yes, that's it! You know, there were so many of them, they were everywhere! Yes, I remember those gnats. Another one of those Hebrew gods' tricks. Well, never mind about that. I'm hungry.
Well, we've got plenty of frog legs. But they're a little smelly.
Yuck, are you kidding me? I don't ever want to see another one of those frogs again. But I'll tell you, I'll give the God of Israel credit. He is creative. Those frogs were everywhere. They were even in the royal bed. Well, I don't want frogs. What else do we have?
Oh, we have some delicious bread.
Nope. Locust ale wheat.
Well, we've got lots of meat.
Nope. All the animals got sick and died.
Well, what else do we eat? Figs? Do we have figs?
Nope. The hail took care of those.
What is that disgusting thing on your face?
Oh, that's a leftover boil from plague number 6.
Tastes like leprosy.
Gross. I've lost my appetite now. I don't even want anything to eat. Just give me something to drink. At least the water's not blood anymore. Now, be gone. I need to be alone.
Aaron, my brother, God has spoken to me. He has told me of one last mighty plague he's going to bring upon Egypt. Pharaoh is finally going to see the power of God.
One last plague. Tell me, brother, about this plague.
Oh, you'll see. Pharaoh's going to pay for his stubbornness. This time, he will finally let our people go. After this plague, he's going to be begging us to leave. Yeah. Let's go tell Pharaoh about this plan.
Oh no, not you two again.
We have a message for you, Pharaoh. The God of Israel has one last plague. He's going to punish you in Egypt for your stubbornness.
This plague will be the worst plague of all. All of Egypt will cry and wail. All of you will bow down and worship God, and you, Pharaoh, and all of Egypt, will beg us to leave.
Pharaoh in Egypt can take whatever it is your God has for us. I'm never going to let your people go. Never!
Zipporah, my wife, how are the preparations coming?
The lamb is almost ready, cooked with the bitter herbs like as God commanded.
How about the bread?
Well, it's done, but it is awfully flat.
Yeah, well, we don't have time for it to rise. We have to get ready. We have to be ready to leave at a moment's notice.
There are many things we need to do for this last plague. I think we now need to mark the door, as God told us to, so that He will protect us. So we will make sure we follow God's instructions so that we will be protected from the last plague.
God is finally delivering us. We will finally be free from Pharaoh and Egypt. Our people have waited so long to be free, but we always knew that God would follow in His promise. What else do we need to do to prepare?
Well, just as every other Israelite is doing with their doors, we need to be ready. Tonight, we're going to eat standing up. We're going to keep our cloaks on, keep your shoes on your feet, and keep staff in hand, because as soon as the Lord passes over, we need to be ready to leave Egypt quick.
Come, let us eat. The time is near.
Without these slaves here, who's going to build all of my stuff? Yeah, I still need a pyramid built. I still need big cities built. Where are my slaves?
I don't think they're coming back.
They are out of here.
They're making a break for it as fast as they can.
G-O-N, gone.
See ya. What do you want to see?
I need those slaves. Assemble the army, gather the chariots, get every available man, bring them back. Not a one of those slaves is going to escape.
And when I get a hold of them, they're gonna pay. They may have a head start, but we have faster horses.
But, sire, all of our horses have died.
No problem. I have these two soldiers here. Give me your whip. I'm the Pharaoh. I give the example. Go straight. Faster. Yeah. 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 Faster. I'm stuck.
Oh, can you believe it? The Egyptians were just throwing their gold and silver at us. They couldn't get rid of us fast enough.
I know. I cannot believe that they were actually let us leave. But one thing, God kept his promise. I think he sent this cloud over here. Surely he's going to keep us safe.
I'm not so sure about this. All I've eaten for 3 days is bread. I want some meat and a bed to sleep in. At least with Pharaoh, I had those things. I know it's a lot of work, but it's better than marching in the desert.
Hey, wait, what's that coming? It looks like a dust cloud.
No, it can't be. No, it is. It's the entire Egyptian army, all of them.
Oh, no.
Chariots, soldiers, swords, spears, they're gonna mow us down. We're gonna die.
Moses, what have you done? I mean, yeah, the work in Egypt was hard, but hey, it beats dying in the desert.
I want to go home! I want my mommy!
Calm down. You will see that God has saved us. You see the Egyptians coming? God is making sure that we will not see them ever again. The Lord, he's going to fight for us. You'll see. I just need to go calm down.
But Moses, how can God possibly save us from their massive army? They're going to run us over with their chariots.
I mean, they have swords and spears and shields. We have whatever this is, and we are no match.
With God, anything is possible, even when they're rolling pin. God has brought us this far. He has been faithful to us. We've seen the plagues that he put into Egypt. He will deliver us. Look, that cloud that has been guiding us. It is now moved in front of the army. They can't see us.
What's that cloud? It's like a sand storm.
I'm in a
class case of emotion. She blinded me with science.
People of Israel, the Lord has told me his plan to rescue us. Come with me to the edge of the Red Sea. He's asked me to raise my staff, and he will part the waters for us.
Whoa. Look at that!
Follow me, people of Israel. Our day of saving is here. God has given us dry land to walk across the sea. God will lead our path.
Oh, finally! The cloud is gone! Now, where'd they go?
Whoa! Would you look at that right there?
Whoa. I am not going anywhere near that. No way, Jose! They have God on their side, and he is against Egypt.
First of all, you know my name is not Jose. It's Victor. But all my good friends call me Vic.
I want nothing to do with that. I can't even swim. I'm glad those slaves are gone. They were nothing but trouble anyway.
You got a name?
I was at your kid's birthday party last month, man.
Well, if we are following them through the sea,
least I brought my floaties.
You all have to be the most pathetic, lazy excuse for an army in the history of the world! What is that? Wait a minute. That's just more of the Israelite God's tricks. I want my slaves back, and I want them back now. Vicky, go first. You all go. Get my slaves.
Moses, look! The Egyptians, they're following us. Now we're all going to die.
Don't worry. God has shown me a plan. When I raise my staff, you will defeat them.
Whoa! What is this trick?
We'll see you tomorrow night.